Okay, I know, big excitement on the Halloween is getting closer. But I actually didn't want to talk about Halloween. It's very blustery outside, that's all. So I have my cape on. I wanted to talk about the removal of the self for the greater good. And unfortunately, it's almost impossible, because by the learning and the obstacles and the encumbrances that occur with the self, person to person, there are learns out of those that can enhance the greater good, you know what I'm saying? Can make the greater good, you know, make sure that doesn't happen to this person or that person or the other, you know? So when you have all of these screams of agonies of the selves, each self is feeling very selfish. Now, this is happening to me, on my roof, or the weather today, you know, all of these things are happening to me, you know, each selfish person is having their selfish moment. But in reality, that's not helping. You know, each little selfish moment isn't helping, is it? It's always like, we're never gonna achieve anything unless it all gets pushed into, is this really for the greater good? You know, is it going into that pile? And we'll push it into the greater good pile. Well, I can bring up the city government. I just read something about sidewalks, because I was interested in sidewalks. Like, this is my sidewalk, you know, can I just tear it up and just say, forget it, I don't want that nasty concrete there, and make them walk on the street or make a little tiny pathway with stones really pretty? Do I have to have that terrible sidewalk? And so then I'm thinking, well, that's kind of something that is not so selfish, and it could affect the greater good. And so I went out there and I looked, and it said in its tantrum of city government ordinances and agendas, it said that the average, the minimum, was 6 feet. 6 feet wide in front of every house. That was what the city is like, yay. They're all like saying that's good, because that makes for active people. They're gonna get on that sidewalk and be active. When in reality, you only need, if you're gonna have to, you know, have sidewalks, you only need 4 feet, which gives 24 inches per person side by side. And so two people can walk comfortably down the street in pair fashion. When you have 6 feet, it does not mean a bicycle goes there. Nobody wants a bicycle on there. Not one person. They want the bicycles in the street on the bicycle lane. They don't want a 24-inch person and then another 24-inch wide person and then another 24-inch wide person. They don't want three people walking down the street together. That's absurd. And I'm looking at it and I'm going, well, this looks like a government that is being funded. That rule is being funded by whoever's supplying the concrete. I want wider sidewalks for my workers. I want more concrete out there for my work effort, you know, so I get more money. So it sounds like it's funding a business, a big business, a concrete business. Way too much. We do not need 6 feet wide ever. That's absurd. Many of these city streets are just way too wide, and we already know that. They fit not only the ongoing and the traffic, the two-way, they fit parked cars, and then they fit a third one. Like, so you have like a space for that chicken lane in the middle in a residential zone. So all of those are going on. You know, it's like you guys went too wide. You know, you can put an island in the middle, you went too wide. Okay, so in essence, they're supposed to say, well, we made a mistake, and just tear up what they did, and then give it back to the homeowners. Get them to have their property back. Because they took easements, way too much easements for city driving, when it's not necessary. You only need one lane, two lane, and then parking. Four lanes across, that's it. They never need any more. They don't need six lanes or five lanes, none of that. So that type of thing is the greater good, because then you stop supporting one concrete firm, one asphalt company. You stop giving them big, fat money pockets, because that's what's going on. Okay, and then I'm like, well, okay, so let's attack the big, fat money pockets, okay? So who do we have? Well, we have the concrete companies. Now, I've just noticed it said 6 feet on every in front of your house is concrete. That's just horrible. Okay, so then we have them to attack, and then we also have who else is a business that is greedy and is getting in there with their contracts? Who else is another greedy? Well, we can attack the fast food industry. We have fast food. Okay, we have obesity here in this region that is just disgusting. We have people that are native Indians, and they switched over to this fast food diet, this Mexican diet. The Mexicans are the second fattest group in the whole world. I mean, that is not something to be proud of. That is something that is saying, oh my gosh, you guys are dying. You're killing yourselves. You're eating wrong things. You're starving inside. You're non-nutritive. All of your insides are rotting out, and you're gonna die premature. You understand? You're killing yourself early. Okay, so the switch from a native Indian diet, especially you can look at the Tarahumaras. There was a program on them. When they switched out and they went into the cities, it's just a scandal. The food just exploded on them. Just exploded. So they became diabetics immediately, and they became obese immediately. Very sad. A very sad situation. So we now are looking at, we have, back to the business, we have the business of fast foods, and we're talking maybe in one major area of a few miles, 10 miles or so, maybe, what, we're looking at 20, 25 owners, 20, 25 business owners only, that are causing obesity amongst the populace of a town. 20 people are making extra unhealthy human beings. Only 20 people. It's just a scandal. Another scandal. So when we get those, now I'm at 21. Okay, so we have the 21 people. That when we have a town of a million, and you have, well, They're not all in one area, I can't say that. But yeah, after a while it might be 100, maybe about 150 people, maybe 200 people in an area of a million that are causing obesity. I mean, it's just disgusting that 200 people are given that much allow. I mean, it's very much up to the government. The government to say, no, not in our town. We won't have fast food restaurants. We don't want your drive-through. It is not healthy. We have too many native Indians. You can call them Mexicans all you want, but we have too many that are obese. Cancel those restaurants, switch them out, don't invite any others in. They're killing the people. They're killing them premature. Okay? That's not the point of a town. Move there and you just get so heavy you can never leave. That is not the point of a town, to kill you off when you're 60 years old, when really you're supposed to live till 90 and 110. It's not the point of the town to damage you health-wise. We need bicycle lanes. We need walking lanes. Also, can be the walking lane, the bicycle lane shared, but we need those all over the place. All over the place. I am not kidding. For safety factor, for all kinds of reasons. Just, you know, talk about making active people. Get out there with your paint stripe and make that. You know, people are not going to be active jogging on sidewalks in front of anybody's house. They will only be active jogging on the street. Active joggers do not go on sidewalks like that unless it's in a park region. I can't believe that that's why they said 6 feet was for to give people physical activity zone. I mean, what a bunch of liars. I can't believe it. I mean, even if it was a mother and her child and their little, like, wheelie machine, it always goes in front of the mother. Doesn't go beside her. In front. It's just ridiculous. Okay? So anyway, so we have to fight this obesity. Those restaurants are not changing. They have not changed. They have not modified. For years and years, they may throw a salad out there and go, ha 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 ha, and it's $7, but the burgers or this or that is 99 cents, you know. Okay, now because these people have become so obese, they are definitely damaged. They're damaged in their brains by now. They're damaged by the food intake. It's just created, their brains have turned in, they're like zombies, they're sugar zombies. They're sugar and rancid fat zombies. Okay, because they have all this cooked fat that they intake that they can't deal with. They have all this sugar, all of this that shoots them up and into, hey, I'm happy at the moment, ugh, crash. Until they get bigger and bigger and bigger. So what I'm trying to say, gosh dang it, where am I? We're talking about the diet change. Now, what we have to do as vegans all around the world is we have to get a really good diet for everybody, one that's inexpensive. It has to be cheap as that 99 cents at the fast food. It has to just bypass them and say, no, I have cheaper food at home. or I brought cheaper food with me, you know. And so we have to make lists of all of this. You know, this is your lunch, and this is how much it costs, and this is not so much to prepare either. You know, it doesn't have to be prepare time forever. It just has to be, unfortunately, everybody, fruits, a lot of fruits. We need a lot of fruits back in our diet. And, you know, when it says it's 80 cents, it's 88 cents a pound, and it's not organic, that's the way it goes. That's going to be better. That's even going to be better than what you're doing at that fast food restaurant. That's going to be better for you. So if you can't do organic, doesn't matter. You still have got to get on that fruit. We have bananas at a pretty much blocked price. Everybody can eat bananas for one meal a day. And that cuts down on costs considerably. Okay, so we have to look at a diet plan that keeps them able to be healthy. You understand? Because right now, they're looking at their pocketbook and say, I only have $5. So they go to those places and they'll get three burgers and a Coke and some fries. And no, that's not the answer. That's just not the answer. That $5 can buy you two mangoes and probably four bananas, maybe an avocado. All of that you could eat, you know. Be healthy, even slim down naturally, and at the same time, my gosh, not be out of pocketbook, because this is what we're really looking at. They've got them by the pocketbook, you know. These fast food restaurants are holding on to them out of cheap, you know. We've got them for the cheap, you know. So we got to get back to say, hey, you know, I have a comparison meal. A comparison meal that is just fine, just as adequate money-wise, but beneficial nutrition-wise. So beneficial nutrition-wise that you will live past 60 years old, you know. You stay on it. You will not die prematurely because of your obesity. Yeah, it's the saddest thing. Anyway, if you can watch that show, it's about the Tarahumaras and the saga. Yeah, long-distance runners. Yow. Long-distance runners gone city, and when they went city, it failed on them. And back to those 200 people, 201 people that are owning each little million, each group of million, and their obesity within. Hunt them down. No, don't hunt them down, but really, I mean, they should never have been given that much authority over other people's bodies, over other people's health. Yeah. Anyway. Because they don't have willpower. The people just don't have willpower. They don't have discipline. They're just looking at their pocketbook. Quick and easy. You know, well, a spoon in your car with an avocado is very quick and easy. Three bananas, four bananas, very quick and easy. A mango, it's a little much, but they need to be eaten at home. But what's the other one? Peaches, apples, all of it, all of that, very quick and easy, you know. Sometimes, what can I say? But vegan me is enjoying my vegan me, and I am convinced that cooked oils are a rancidity to my body and create a stomach ache. Any cooked oils give me a stomach ache. immediately, like within 2 minutes of eating a cooked oil. So that's my learn recently. So let's ban those. Let's ban those. You can all learn from me on my exodus of the cooked oils. All right, 201 of you, find another vocation. How about that?